I'm Ralph Hutton. I'm here in heaven for the finals of Mr. Gay UK. In an hour's time, I'll be coming out in front of 2,000 people, plus my friends at home watching passengers on their television sets.
This is and we pay several visits to this week's diarist, Ralph Hutton, who's decided to openly declare his sexuality and come out in style by entering the Mr. Gay UK contest.
I only came out to myself a year ago. Someone who described me as not being a stereotypical gay man. I fought against it since I was about 12, but I only admitted to it like less than a year ago. When I was younger, when I was about 15, 16, I mean, Blackpool used to be a resort, and that used to be a laugh. I used to go out and get trolleyed and just, you know, have a good time. But when I came out to myself as a gay man, my view of Blackpool changed quite dramatically.
It takes Ralph an hour to drive the 50 miles from his home to the nearest gay club.
This is Flamingo's nightclub, one of the most famous gay nightclubs in Great Britain, and this is where I became Mr. Gay Blackpool. Which is rather strange considering nobody back home knows I'm gay. I count bets for you,
one in a million men. My first impressions of the gay scene were, this is a bit sleazy, and you obviously notice that this isn't a straight club when you walk in. Baby, it sucks
to me. There's men walking about with backsides cut out of underwear and things, and I wasn't used to that because I've only been on the scene. This is my scene. Since last Easter. I hadn't really been here that much, so I didn't feel comfortable. And I figured the only way to feel comfortable would be to get up on stage in front of everybody and confront my fears. In a couple of days, it's the finals for Mr. Gay UK. Anything could happen, and a few people will be shocked.
Never seen no leg in your life, look at that.
In order to get some advice for the forthcoming contest, Ralph has enlisted the help of legendary drag act, the Sex Kittens.
Well, the main thing to do is thrash your knob in people's faces, dear. That's what seems to get by.
Give me a man after midnight. Won't somebody help me chase the shadows away?
Don't mini, don't no shoulders, darling. Remember, you're a man. Keep it up straight and forward.
Gotta have some high stuff, got to have some love.
So what are you going to wear then for this thing?
I came up with the idea of, well, first impressions, trying to create an image.
And what image was that?
Well, the image I thought was a cross between Kevin Costner in The Bodyguard and Terminator.
Yeah, but you see, the thing is, first impressions, if you come out in all this sort of flash gear, people are going to say, oh, she's a flash cow. Well, and then when you come out in your drawers, they'll go, oh, she's still a flash cow. But if you keep it like, you know, play it down, darling, bit like this, bit like me now, people can go, oh, isn't this sweet, isn't it lovely, lovely, can't wait from seeing with the drawers off. How old are you?
I'm 26, but the funny thing is, this whole process is like, it's me coming out, really. It's like,
oh, you're coming out on television? Well,
so
all these
people
coming out
very discreet.
Well, no. What happened was, I mean,
I was.
My sister knows. I told
she
her.
She knows
her,
now.
I told her last. Yeah. She doesn't. If I win, I'll tell my mum.
And reminder, don't forget, if you do want to go down to heaven in London, support our entrant from Mr. Gay UK, that's Ralph Hutton. You can get on the coach on Sunday morning at 9:45 in the car park.
I've travelled a lot in my life, and I've always come back to Kendal. And when I've come home, it's felt like home. And they all know me as Big Ralph. I mean, obviously, the connotations might change slightly when they find out I'm gay.
You're a person who keeps a lot to themselves. You don't always open up. That will be to your advantage in later life.
I've only told one close friend at home, and he's the only person who knows at home, apart from my sister, now, and her husband, who I told last week.
Well, I used to go to school every day on the math, been to a party, and the girl had been there. And it got to me that he was kissing this girl at the party. And he came out with this comment going, oh, what a sloppy kisser you are. And I thought, well, you know, he obviously doesn't like girls too much if he comes out with a comment like that. So I wasn't surprised.
What's that going to do with anything?
I don't understand that at all.
Right, it's got the same front as the other one.
Oh, and yes, I've seen
it's like
before.
A t-shirt. Oh, there you go.
So there's going to be a picture of you in here today.
What's that? I love people who are prepared to be themselves, even in the face of adversity.
Yeah,
that's supposedly the biggest rival.
He's the only one who's got his pictures with a smile. Everybody else has got like mean looks, I think.
He looks kind of mean. He looks like something out of EastEnders, doesn't he? Like,
he's got a bit of a rough-looking Mickey Rock sort of like.
Well, there's only about three. He's not bad. There's only about three that I think are decent, but usually it's the strange ones that win, isn't it?
Kendal is a sleepy market town on the edge of the Lake District. Ralph has lived there with his family for 21 years.
I really don't see where my future's going in Kendal. It's the kind of place that it's good to bring up children and it's good to have a family.
We're holding a formal for you today. Paul Liam.
A male model.
A male model? Why'd you say that? Go on, Phil, why'd you say that?
Oh, you're gorgeous, aren't you?
Oh, thanks so much, Phil.
Everyone loves you,
right?
I think that a lot of gay men find it hard simply because of the way they may have discovered their sexuality to settle down with one partner. My first sexual experience, as far as being a gay man's concerned, was having when I was 14 with a friend. It was him, it wasn't me at all. We were just out and we'd been swimming and stuff, and he kind of like said or suggested, what would you do with a woman if you were having sex? And he kind of got on top of me and started rolling around, and one thing led to another. And I thought, we must be gay. And I verbalised that. And as soon as I verbalised it, it was like, bang, that friendship was over. It frightened the pants off him.
It tells me there's someone else, but you haven't met her yet.
Right.
You've got me all carried away. I wasn't going to tell you all this.
So there's someone else I haven't met yet?
Yes. Yeah.
And I'll end up having three kids?
Yeah.
Our diarist, 26-year-old Ralph Hutton, still lives with his family in the little village of Kendal near the Lake District. As we join him, he's leaving for London for the finals of Mr. Gay UK.
As a coach running via Lancaster University from my college through Blackpool down to London. I'd say two-thirds of the people on the coach are straight, and they're going to support me because they're my friends, not because they're curious. I suppose they are slightly about what it's all about.
I want a t-shirt, lick me till I scream.
Have you seen this? Catch a load of...
Well, speak your mind.
This is where we're going. I'm getting a bit concerned, like, you know.
Just saw some pictures of Heaven Nightclub. Totally outrageous.
I'm heterosexual, but I have a lot of friends who are homosexual. It doesn't bother me in the slightest. As long as they don't try and push it down my throat, I don't try and push my heterosexuality down there, so.
No, I think he'll love marching through Lancaster with his tiara on and things and his sash. Love it. If he loses, he'll have to leave the area.
I was very attracted to him, and it was a bit of a blow really, thinking that something could happen, but it's never going to, because we're both very aware of the circumstances.
What car was it in?
What?
You and Ralph.
What, did you start with Ralph? I wasn't supposed to say that.
Have you?
It was,
yeah,
he has. No, it was his house, actually.
I didn't know that.
Was
I
it?
Thought he had you in the back of a car.
No, it wasn't a car. Is it Ralph's home?
I'm dead.
You've dead. Gone red. I can feel it, you bit. I'm going to get back for that. It was good at the time, yeah. I was very shy, actually. It was like... I ran home. I was, honestly. I just didn't know whether to suck it and play baseball with it. It was like...
We're meeting in the club about 10:30. For the rest of you, all right? As for me, I'll be there from, I don't know what time, 10 o'clock, probably. Just enjoy it.
Good luck, Ralph.
Good luck, Ralph!
Thanks, cheers. I'll see you there, all right?
Passengers diarist Ralph Hutton has left the tranquil Lake District town of Kendal and travelled down to London for the prestigious Mr. Gay UK contest. Battle is about to commence.
Give me more than you want. It don't mean a thing if you can't hold him down.
The celebrity panel of judges, including Jean-Paul Gaultier and Michael Cashman, scored the contestants on personality as well as looks.
Behind these televisions is the creme de la creme of gay men selected from nightclubs, public houses, lavatories, etc. from up and down the country.
In the northwest.
He can do what the fuck he likes to me any time of the day or night. He can smear my body in custard and liquor.
And now for the most popular part of the contest, the underwear section.
People watching me in my underwear on stage, I'll be sweating. I'll probably only look at the first two lines of people and ignore everybody else, black them out completely. I'll either go two ways. I'll either cram up or I'll become an extreme exhibitionist.
It's down to about four or five guys, I reckon, for first place. There's about four or five guys for second place, the same again. May the best guy win. See what happens.
My
With the finals of Mr. Gay UK just hours away, Ralph meets his rivals.
Pierce nipples or anything would be wonderful.
We'd like to see them.
Okay.
No knob out.
When I first walked in the door, I looked around and I thought, oh my God, there's a lot of models in here. And I thought, no, no. I've seen the brochure. These are not the same people.
Have you got a party piece that you're doing for us, or are you just coming on looking lovely?
I'm just coming on as myself.
You're looking lovely and coming on. Right, okay.
One of the competitors did a little dance routine and he sang along and he was down. And it was very professional. It looked like he'd been doing it all his life. And just before he left the stage, he sort of said something about it. That's better than any rugby ball or something. And his routine was very good. And I thought, you know, how am I going to match anything like that?
Anybody who hasn't got their clothing, flesh clothing, you want to come and pick out what you want. There's shorts, swimwear.
I don't want anything like teeny or like grabby or anything. What about something along the lines of like a jock strap, but not quite, but not that small? I don't want to go like that.
Semi see through?
No, thank you.
We're doing those steps in the corner there. There's a dressing room if you throw your knickers on there. Right.
I'm not sure what I'm wearing the second time I go on yet. And it's 7:15. I'm worried about that. But...
The club starts to fill up with the more flamboyant members of London's gay community. Meanwhile, the competitors are limbering up.
Hi, Tamina's mum, alright. Does she know you dress up like this?
Yes.
She does.
She gave me this handbag.
Tonight's hostess is the inimitable Lily Savage.
The Flamingo Club in Blackpool, which is an excellent club. He's aged 26, he's 6'6", got a 40-foot-inch chest, 30-foot-inch waist, and he's a student. He likes swimming, basketball, walks golf, and he's coming to live with me after the competition. Thank you very much. Have you seen my makeup?
Can you believe?
Swines. I haven't got time to clean it out. I'm very busy. Two children and a whippet. I can sound like Psycho Savage tonight. I'm trying to get my notes together. But yeah, it'll be a good night. Yeah, it'll be smashing.
For passengers diarist Ralph Hutton, the moment of truth has arrived.
In third place, from Route 66 Club, would you welcome, please,
to be Mr. Gay UK. They think he's great. I think he should model.
Stick to acting or something like that.
Acting? You think I should do that?
Yeah, definitely.
Well, thank you.
You've got a cheeky face.
Cheeky face.
Honesty.
is the only commodity you are born with and you die with, and it comes from your heart. Well done.
Thank you.
I bet your mum will probably turn and said I knew anyway.
Right.
They usually do.
Good advice. Should have won. Is your mother going to be watching this?
Oh, I don't know, actually. I might have, well, I'm going to tell her before it goes out, because other people will tell her about it.
Well, otherwise. Being a mother myself, I'd just like to say, if you were to see a mum, you should be very proud of this young man, because he's charming, he's good-looking, he's got lots of bottle, so please don't chastise him when this comes out and you're sat on the couch doing your knitting and you haven't got a clue what's going on. Give the lad a big cheer instead.
Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
You're a star. Thanks.
Nice to win, but I don't feel it's like a great loss. It was nice to take part, it was nice to meet all the entrants, and the process was more important to me than the actual winning at the end of the day.
Despite coming fifth in the Mr. Gay UK contest, Ralph has still not told his mother he's gay.